This has come at a time when road accidents are on the rise in the country. The deaths on the roads intensified more during the festive season, according to the traffic police reports from the 23rd to the 26th. In December last year, 55 people died and more than 50 lives were lost between the 28th of December and the 1st of January. To make matters worse, on January 6th this year, 16 people died in an accident on the Gulu Highway. Those who survived the accidents stay with permanent injuries, and the medical workers have today reported an overwhelming number of accident victims at Mulago Hospital. Though they have made a commitment to try their best to save the lives of Ugandans, they have made several demands to the government, which need to be considered to reduce the alarming rate of road accidents, including retesting and physical examination for passenger vehicles and buses every 6 to 12 weeks. They are demanding for mental and eye tests of drivers to ascertain their medical conditions before being given a driving license. They have called for availability of well-equipped ambulances, surgeons and physicians, insurance of road users, among others.
We receive you in whatever state you are, whether you're crushed or you are mildly injured. If the leg needs to be cut off, we are the ones who cut off the head. If the brain needs to be poured out and then poured back, we are the ones who do it. When you die, we are the ones who roll you. So we see the nasty bit of everything beyond the public and the media. That's why we are concerned. So we are concerned on two fronts, as human beings, as Ugandans. I have personally had an accident in 2003. I had a very bad accident, and I'm full of metals and plates in myself. So I have a conflict of interest there. But as a doctor who receives patients and either sends them home alive or disabled or dead, I'm also concerned.
We usually get a lot of stockouts for these life-saving drugs in the hospitals, so we urge the government and Minister of Health to ensure that we get enough of these drugs in the government hospitals. Then the other issue is about the insurance companies where we pay third party. Many Ugandans, including those ones who are even educated, surely do not know that when you get an accident, you have a right to claim some money from insurance to aid your treatment. So this information is not open to the public. So we request that the insurance companies provide this information to the public so that people can know that they can actually access some money to aid their treatment when they're involved in road traffic accidents.
According to the president of the Association of Surgeons, Dr. Asimwe Rubaninda, the government should take into account every road user when planning for roads.
Having a multidisciplinary, multimodal approach. We need government to set laws. When they are planning roads, they need to take care of all the road users, from the vehicles, the motorcyclists, to the cyclists, because they move at different speeds, to the pedestrian crossings. All those have got to be considered, how many lanes you are putting. But you realize that a highway like the Entebbe Express Highway, very well done. Still, the accidents are very high, partly because of the guy behind the wheel and whatever is influencing them, and the vehicle, mostly.
In order to minimize accidents, the World Health Organization says effective interventions that should be carried out include designing safer infrastructure and incorporating road safety features into land use and transport planning, improving the safety features on vehicles, improving post-crash care for victims of road crashes, setting and enforcing laws relating to key risks, and raising public awareness. Story by Jaliat Namoya for the news.